What if the calm and more peaceful periods of our sun actually affect seismic and volcanic activity right here on Earth? Could a silent solar cycle trigger volcanic eruptions that reshape life here on Earth? Sounds like something out of science fiction, right? But hey, stick with me because today we're exploring a fascinating and slightly unnerving connection between solar activity and volcanic eruptions. And might I add, backed by hard evidence. As I'm sure many people watching this video already know, our sun goes through an 11-year solar cycle, oscillating between periods of high activity marked as sunspots and solar flares, and low activity known as solar minimus. Solar minimus are times of quiet and fewer sunspots and reduced energy output. Now, here's where things do get really interesting. Some scientists believe that there's a link between these quiet periods and increased volcanic activity on Earth. The sun's nap time might actually make our planet more hectic when it comes to powerful volcanic eruptions. Let's look at some historical data. During the Dalton Minimum, a period of reduced solar activity from around 1790 to 1830, Earth experienced a series of intense volcanic eruptions. One of the most famous was Mount Tambora in 1815, the largest eruption in recorded history. It spewed out so much ash into the atmosphere that global temperatures actually dropped, causing what's now called the Year Without a Summer. Crops failed, and there was actually widespread famine across the Northern Hemisphere. And guess what? This wasn't an isolated event. The Maunder Minimum, another prolonged solar quiet phase in the 17th century, also coincided with increased volcanic activity in the Little Ice Age. Yes, now many are going to cry foul and say correlation and patterns do not equate to connection. But follow me because things are about to get even stranger. This is a study I dug out on ResearchGate, and it found something really intriguing. It states that while Earth has been going through a recent warming period, which has been from 1900 to present day, it showed a strong link between volcanic activity in the solar minimum phase. But back in history, during periods where the Earth was cooling, from 1615 to 1751, the opposite happened. Volcanic activity shot up during solar maximum phases. And there is another very interesting study found right here. It also concluded something pretty interesting, and that is that the Carrington event of 1880 is suspected to have started the recent migration of the magnetic North Pole. Now, this study is a great read if you do have the time, and you can find it linked down below. But before you hurry off and read that, what is causing this connection, this relationship? Well, scientists are still investigating it, but there are a few theories being thrown around. One theory points to changes in the Earth's climate. Solar minimus slightly reduced global temperatures, which could shift pressure systems in the atmosphere and potentially trigger geological activity like earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. This theory is still being debated, but it highlights how interconnected our planet is with the sun, or is potentially with the sun. Another idea focuses on Earth's magnetic field. During solar minimus, the sun's magnetic activity weakens, which could allow more cosmic rays to penetrate Earth's atmosphere. This might, in turn, affect processes deep within our planet like magma movement and tectonic activity. As much as supervolcanoes and big earthquakes are negative to humanity, it isn't all doom and gloom here. The beauty of science is its ability to help us prepare. Satellites like NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory are keeping a close eye on the sun, while geological monitoring systems track volcanic activity worldwide. In fact, advancements in early warning systems means we're actually better equipped than ever to predict and respond to disasters. And hey, history shows that humanity has always adapted to these challenges. The volcanic winters of the past did not stop human progress. They actually inspired innovation in agriculture, energy, and even migration patterns. So, is the sun's calm really linked to volcanic fury? The evidence is compelling, but the story isn't fully written. Let's keep this conversation going in the comment section, and if you want to learn about some more interesting mysteries surrounding the wonderful world that we live in, subscribe for future content. And do check out the video on screen to learn something else about this weird and wonderful world that we inhabit. And until next time, guys, stay curious.